my god. Hey everyone, it is Future Jack. So I filmed this video not too long ago. But turns out information, especially in theme parks, moves pretty quick. And a lot of the information that I've given in this video has now proven to be incorrect and false. So I'm going to be interjecting myself here and there at multiple points in this video in order to present you with the most accurate, up-to-date information. Just so that you guys know. Hey everybody, we are back in the parks, more specifically Universal, more specifically Islands of Adventure. That feels like a really weird way to start this off. Anyways, I'm back. I took a few weeks off of the parks as a bit of a breather, and sometimes that's needed. But I'm happy to be back here with the sounds of Screaming Hulk behind me. Because things have changed around the resort. First and foremost, the most significant change we've seen in well over a year. To be fair, I still have to keep this in my pocket, I have to keep it with me, but those individuals like myself that are fully vaccinated and ready to party, we don't have to wear it outdoors anymore. We do have to put it on indoors, so retail, rides, that kind of thing, restaurants. We do have to wear these still. If you are fully vaccinated, you don't have to have a mask at all, indoor or outdoor. That is a change that was made since I recorded this. Now I'm going to throw it back to Past Jack and continue on. Let me tell you, the breeze on my cheeks, haven't felt in a while. I've not felt that in a while. Another change going on at this specific park is that the Velocicoaster opens up on June 10th, officially. But they are doing what they call public technical rehearsals. They did the same thing with the Bourne Stunt Show about a year and a half ago. And let me tell you, the Bourne Stunt Show, I can't remember the exact opening date, but we saw it like easily five times before it actually officially opened to the public. And you can too. Today, if you come into Islands of Adventure, for example, it is about an 85-minute wait. It's going to be a standby, you know, it's going to be a little grueling, you know, but you can, in fact, ride the Velocicoaster, and I'm very excited to do so. The only thing with that is that I'm not actually allowed to film it, so that is not the point of this video. But there's so much going on that I'm not even gonna focus on it. The point of today's video is that Mardi Gras at Universal Studios actually has ended. I know, the joke around town was that it was never going to end, but they did end it. And then immediately started yet another food fest. So we'll definitely be walking around and getting some food and trying as much stuff as we can. Flashback to this video, where all clickbait and theatrics aside, most of those rides did reopen. The only attraction that really didn't on that list was Barney. It has since been replaced with a DreamWorks dance party show, and I'm excited to see a dance party featuring Puss in Boots and Shrek and Trolls and Madagascar, and I think Kung Fu Panda might be thrown in there. And let's get to it. Thank you. Now we have officially made it to the other side. And by the other side, I mean the Universal Studios side. The Summer Food Fest seems to be a bit smaller than I was expecting. Instead of tents set up all around the lagoon, it's a select few food trucks. In other news, there is a Jurassic World tribute store coming soon. Of course, there is no set opening date for that, but my money says June 10th. They gotta capitalize on that Jurassic World merch the day that Velocicoaster opens, and honestly, I respect it.
Yeah, that prediction was wrong. They are not opening it up on June 10th with the Velocicoaster. They went ahead and opened it on May 27th. So, we're not going to be exploring the inside of this video, the inside of the tribute store in this video, obviously. But if you want to go and subscribe and ring the little bell, I am planning on doing a video from the inside of the tribute store soon. Just not this one. Back to the show.
Looks like our first food truck will be located here right in front of Fast and Furious Supercharge.
Where I was able to get a very nice pressed Cuban and a bottle of water.
And might I say, everything is a tad bit more expensive, but the portions are also kind of huge. So when I finish this sandwich, I'm not 100% sure how many more of these booths I'll be able to hit. Maybe we could just try something new every time we come. It might be fun. Anyways, on to this. You guys know how much I love our nice fresh Cuban. So, okay. This tastes a lot like the Cuban that they had for Mardi Gras. But no complaints there. The Cuban they had for Mardi Gras was pretty much a darn perfect Cuban. The only complaint I have was that it was too small. This is a lot bigger. This is a good meal-sized portion, and it's got some kind of seasoning on the bread, like maybe some kind of garlic butter or something. It's a nice touch.
Jesus.
Almost just got attacked by a pigeon there. That was interesting. Let me tell you though, best theme park Cuban I've ever had. I'll come back for it. Hopefully they keep it longer than summer. I'm gonna move on now.
And there it is, everyone. There's the entrance for DreamWorks Destination. And it's totally roped off with no showtimes posted. By looking in, we can see I'm not 100% sure what that is. That's Trolls. Is that on Netflix? I think so. Am I officially old? Looks like we just gotta wait for it to start opening up. Turns out, you know what, it explains why I haven't heard an opening date on this one. It's a lot like the Velocicoaster, where it's open, but it's not open. It's under what we call technical rehearsal.
All right, and even though I just said that they're in technical rehearsal, they went ahead and opened it. So, even though there's not much of a change, just know that it is, in fact, open to the public now.
Hey, it's Caitlin the Kingdom from YouTube and TikTok and Instagram. And I don't know, we ran into each other. We're gonna go film the same thing.
The characters are gonna dance around. They're gonna sing. They're gonna do their show. They're gonna come to us. They said, we are DreamWorks VIPs.
Looks like we've certainly upgraded Barney's Park. Yeah, the decorations in here are looking pretty awesome. You got the DreamWorks logo up here. We got, you know, Madagascar and Trolls and Kung Fu Panda, Puss in Boots, just like I said. But here's my opinion. I don't know if you guys wanna listen or care. You know what movie they need to make? They need to make a movie on who the DreamWorks moon fisherman boy is. I would watch that. So Kayla and the Kingdom did remind me. We've never seen the boy, but we saw, like, he put a, you know, like a fish on his hook,
and threw it into the water, and that actually did interact with the beginning of Shark's Tale. I just didn't like Shark's Tale enough to go back and watch it.
I see your best moves. And we go. Like I said, you guys are the VIPs.
So what you guys just saw is the first batch, I assume, of these characters.
There's no need for you to leave your section.
They're going to come out. They're going to dance.
Now these folks have
then everybody gets
arrived
to take pictures of the photo spot. And then they're going to bring out more characters.
Oh, we got Poppy, and we got Tiger, and we got Alex. Nice. Oh, this is so cool. Not only do you guys get trivia, you get sweet, sweet dance moves and pictures with every single character. Catch me filling up my Instagram with this show. I didn't know there was going to be this much picture taking. My hair looks terrible today. We got this girl from Puss in Boots. We got this glittery guy from Trolls. Gotta admit, not a big Trolls fan. And then we got Poe. I know like one person from this batch. That's so exciting.
So, DreamWorks Destination was something.
I'm uncomfortable.
What are you telling TikTok? How do you feel?
I feel very weird.
I feel like they ripped off Disney Junior. All in all, I think if you do have kids, it's cute. It's very cute. If you guys have kids, take your kids. Your kids will enjoy dancing around. You'll enjoy getting some lovely family memories of you with Poe or Puss in Boots or the Trolls, you know, that kind of thing. Definitely worth a checkout. I think me as a 26-year-old male, probably shouldn't have been in there for more than 20 minutes, but you know, it is what it is. Oh, we're outside now. Ooh.
We're free again.
I forgot about how good that feels.
That will about do it this time, though. Go ahead and subscribe down below for weekly adventures. Ring that little bell icon for notifications on every single episode. And see you guys next time.